Don't speak ill of the dead and familiar spirits. Movie clip from Ghost at the end. Hi, y'all. I had some of my guides bring me a phrase the other day that I haven't heard in a long time called, Don't Speak Ill of the Dead. And I asked them about that, and they said, well, you know, there's a lot of beings out here, and a lot of them know how to do things with their mind power, and when you start speaking ill of one person's family, then that family may come after you, and that's like the Hatfields and the McCoys type of thing. And it can continue onwards in the spirit world, because when a person dies, you know, physical body dies, they're in the same state of mind that they were in when they left. They don't know about reincarnation. You know, what makes you think they're going to know about reincarnation once they cross over into the spirit world? But if they can get into hearing and communicating and start listening to some of the things that people are saying, or maybe they're upset because some family member is being attacked, so they go after the person that's attacking them, and on and on and on forever. So I guess what they're saying is, if you know that there's a spirit world around, and that spirit world can be subjected to, and, you know, hate can be, you know, ensued because of it, you should be careful with what you say. Now, yeah, you may not have liked Uncle Joe because he was an alcoholic, but what if Uncle Joe's still seeing around you, listening to everything that you're saying, every derogatory remark that you're making, and what are you going to do to stop him from coming after you for it in his own density? Or say, you know, like my brother when passed away, when I was under spirit attack, he was doing all he could to come after me to help me in all the things that I was going through. Now, some people may say that's a familiar spirit, but, you know, I loved my brother when he was alive. Why wouldn't I still love him? My mother passed away. I felt her energy around me a number of times. Why wouldn't I still love her? So, in that sense of the word, if they're out there doing all they can to help me, keep people away from me or whatever, that's just one part of the whole concept of that phrase, don't speak ill of the dead. And I think it's really should be expanded to the fact of maybe we should start thinking about what we're saying in totality. Don't speak ill of anyone. You know, understand what they may be going through, try to deal with it. And I know that's a difficult concept for people to grasp a hold on, because there are so many people out there doing some really wicked things. But where is it going to start? You know, who's going to start it? I truly believe that, you know, we're all here to help. And we shouldn't just be counting on God or Jesus or Muhammad or Abraham or Moses or whoever to do the work for us. It's like everyone's sitting around saying, oh, he's going to come and save us. Well, what about you saving yourself? Okay? Think about that the next time you speak ill of the dead, or ill of anyone, for that matter. Because they may have familiar spirits around them ready to take you down the minute you do. All right? Something to chew on, people. Thanks for watching. Hugs and peace.